We've already seen a few commands that work with file names. For example, ls lists the names of the files in the current directory. Right now we have just one file, things.zip. Let's go ahead and unzip that so we have more files to work with. If you didn't download things.zip earlier, refer to the instructor's note below for instructions. The unzip command typically takes one argument, the file name of the file to unzip. As it works, unzip lists the files and directories it's uncompressing. Let's use ls to see all these new files. It looks like we have some text files and some directories too. Another useful command is cat. Give cat a list of file names, and it'll print out the contents of the files. For example, we can read bivalves.txt and gastropods.txt by running this command. Cat is a funny name for a command, but it makes sense when you realize it's an abbreviation for concatenate. Cat concatenates files and outputs the result. You can also use cat to read a single file. Just give it one file name. A lot of people use cat as their go-to command for reading short files. Later on in the course, we'll learn other ways of reading files that work well with larger files. If you are watching closely, you might have noticed that I was able to type those commands with superhuman speed. I'm not actually a very good typist, though. I was just using one of the shell's built-in time-saving features, tab completion. If you press the tab key while typing a word, the shell will try to autocomplete it for you. For example, I can cat bivalves.txt by tapping cat bi and pressing tab. Since bivalves.txt is the only file that starts with bi, the shell can autocomplete it for me. But what happens if you use tab completion when there's more than one match? Let's try it. Two files start with gas, gastropods.txt and gastropodsdraft.txt. When I hit the tab key, the shell autocompletes as far as it can. If I hit tab again, the shell will tell me all the files that match. Since I want to read gastropodsdraft.txt, I can type an underscore and press tab again to enter the complete file name. All right, we've read files from the command line, but we can do more than that. There are also commands for analyzing files. WC is the word count program. It tells us how many lines, words, and bytes are in a file. Since bivalves.txt has one species per line and two lines of citations, we know that the file describes 10 different critters. Another command for analyzing files is diff. Diff compares files and shows you how they differ. This can be useful if you have multiple versions or editions of the same file, and you want to know what changes have been made. In this case, it looks like the left file, gastropods.txt, has one line that the right file, gastropodsdraft, doesn't have. This little angle bracket points in the direction of the file that includes the change.